Another year has come to an end. Another year spent on this beautiful planet that we humans call Earth and home. Another orbit around the sun, and another bunch of kilometers gallivanting around the galaxy. 2020, what a year. How have you been feeling during these last 366 days? Do you think of yourself as the same person that walked into the 20s? Or are you a different person? While our lives and daily routine changed completely this year, and we don't know when exactly life will get back to normal, there was no rest for science, and discoveries were not lacking. We found phosphine on Venus, water on the moon in more places than NASA thought, a mysterious signal from Proxima Centauri, and so on. Also, we saw Crew Dragon's astronauts leaving Earth and reaching the ISS. And last but not least, some days ago, we were on YouTube waiting for the Starship's belly flop. But what will 2021 be like? Ladies and gentlemen, fasten your seatbelts, because we are going to dive into a new year. Join me on this journey to get to know more about the major astronomical events that are going to take part next year. Take this video as the astronomical calendar for the year 2021. Enjoy. January 2nd, Earth at perihelion, Isaac Asimov's birthday. On January 2nd, 2021, the Earth will be at perihelion. What does it mean? Perihelion is the point in the orbit of a planet, asteroid, or comet at which it is closest to the Sun. And perihelion not only is a body traveling at its highest velocity, but it is also the most effective and efficient moment to alter the object's orbital trajectory. By applying small calculated changes at perihelion, you can completely alter your course. On the same day, we will celebrate Isaac Asimov's birthday. He was a famous writer and professor. We suggest you take a look at his books. January 4th, Quadrantids meteor shower, Isaac Newton's birthday. One of the best annual meteor showers, peaking at up to 120 meteors per hour. The Quadrantids are usually active between the end of December and the second week of January, and peak around January 3rd to 4th. Unlike other meteor showers that tend to stay at their peak for about 2 days, the peak period of the Quadrantids only lasts a few hours. Keep an eye to the sky and remember to eat a piece of cake in honor of one of the greatest scientists of all time, Sir Isaac Newton. January 10th, Triple Conjunction, Frank Sinatra's birthday. Some days ago, we had the opportunity to see the Jupiter-Saturn conjunction in the sky. Prepare yourself, because on January 10th, Jupiter, Saturn, and Mercury will appear close to each other in the evening sky. We will have what is called a triple conjunction. And if you like Frank Sinatra, you can watch this fantastic triple conjunction with his music in the background, because on January 10th, it will be his birthday. January 24th. Saturn at solar conjunction. A solar conjunction occurs when a planet or other solar system object is on the opposite side of the Sun from the Earth. From an Earth reference, the Sun will pass between the Earth and the object. Communication with any spacecraft in solar conjunction will be severely limited due to the Sun's interference on radio transmissions from the spacecraft. On January 24th, Saturn will pass close to the Sun and will be unobservable for weeks to come. January 29th, Jupiter at solar conjunction. After Saturn, also Jupiter will pass close to the Sun and will be unobservable for weeks to come. February, nothing relevant. Maybe we could just mention the Alpha Centauri meteor shower on February 8th, 2021. March the 11th, Neptune at solar conjunction. The blue planet will pass close to the Sun and will no longer be observable for weeks to come. Did you know that you could sink if you stood on Neptune? The gravitational force on Neptune is just 0.17 times stronger than the Earth's gravity. Standing on the surface of the planet without sinking is, however, not possible, as it is a ball of gas and ice. March 20th, spring equinox, Buzz Aldrin's birthday. The word equinox comes from medieval Latin equinoxium. For Latin, equinoctium, the time of equal days and nights. At the equinox, the Sun shines directly over the equator. March 20th is the first day of spring in the north and autumn in the south. Also on March 20th, 2021, Buzz Aldrin will blow out the candles as he'll turn 91 years old. Happy birthday, Buzz. Wait, you don't know who he is? Oh boy. Aldrin, together with Armstrong and Collins, was an Apollo 11 mission astronaut. It was launched to the moon on July 16, 1969. 4 days later, Armstrong and Aldrin landed near the edge of the Sea of Tranquility. After spending about 2 hours gathering rock samples, taking photographs, and setting up scientific equipment for tests, they concluded their lunar surface excursion. Armstrong and Aldrin later piloted the lunar module Eagle to a successful rendezvous with Collins and the command module in lunar orbit. The mission ended on July 24th with a splashdown in the Pacific Ocean. March 28th, first supermoon. The first supermoon of 2021. The moon will appear slightly bigger and brighter than average. The term supermoon was coined in 1979 and is often used today to describe what astronomers would call a perigean full moon, a full moon occurring near or at the time when the moon is at the closest point in its orbit around the Earth. March 29th, Venus at its brightest. This will be a great chance to see the planet in the evening sky. Venus, at its brightest, has an average magnitude of -4.7. Of course, the planet doesn't shine. Planets have no light source of their own, unlike the numerous stars throughout the universe. However, it is sometimes possible for the surface of a planetoid to reflect light from a nearby star, giving it the illusion that it shines, much like the moon. April 17th, lunar occultation of Mars. An occultation occurs when one celestial body passes in front of another. Bodies in the solar system occult stars and occasionally occult one another. Lunar occultations of stars are more frequent than any other kind, due to the large apparent size of the moon and its rapid motion through the sky. Many years ago, lunar occultations provided a ready means of comparing the position of the moon and stars at specific instants in time, and therefore could be used to validate and update theories of the lunar orbit. Nowadays, although they have little scientific value, they remain an interesting spectacle for the amateur observer. The red planet will disappear behind the moon for the first time in 2021 on April 17th. Be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve and make these videos better for you, the viewer. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel, clicking the bell so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. May 6th, Eta Aquarid meteor shower and George Clooney's birthday. If you want to do something special with the person you love, you should probably take a car and drive to a place where the sky is clear in order to enjoy the amazing Aquarid meteor shower. These are fireballs from Halley's Comet up to 40 meteors per hour. Oh, P.S. On April 17th, you can wish George Clooney a happy birthday. He will be turning 60. May 26th. Total lunar eclipse. If you are from Oceania, the Americas, and Eastern and Southeast Asia, I'm sure you won't miss this spectacular total lunar eclipse on May 26, 2021. Lunar eclipses occur on a full moon night when the Sun, Earth, and Moon are aligned in a straight line or almost straight line in space. Anyone on the night side of the Earth at the time of the eclipse can see it. Viewing most lunar eclipses requires little effort. Partial and total eclipses of the Moon are very easy to see as long as you have a clear view of the moon and the sky. May 29th, Venus and Mercury, John F. Kennedy's birthday. On May 29th, you'll get to see an astronomy rarity that is sure to please. A close pairing of Venus and Mercury will grace the dusk sky, creating the closest planet conjunction that we are likely to see in 2021, and one of the easiest times to see Mercury as well. Venus and Mercury will pass within 0 degrees 24 minutes of each other on May 29th. They will be so close. Prepare your telescopes and send us some photos. This will be a special day because it will be President John F. Kennedy's birthday. Let's celebrate. June 10th, annular solar eclipse. Visible from Canada, Greenland, the US, Europe, and Russia, a beautiful annular solar eclipse. But what's an annular solar eclipse? An annular solar eclipse happens when the moon covers the sun's center, leaving the sun's visible outer edges to form a ring of fire, or annulus, around the moon. The name annular comes from the Latin word for ring, annulus. These eclipses are named for their darkest or maximum point, even if it only lasts less than a second. If the characteristic ring of fire is visible from even just one location, the whole eclipse is called an annular solar eclipse. June 21st, summer solstice, Prince Philip's birthday. The sun will shine directly over the Tropic of Cancer. While the calendar may say June 1st was the first day of summer, the season actually starts when the summer solstice happens, according to astronomers. That's because meteorologists divide the year into four seasons based on weather patterns. So the summer solstice always occurs later than the first day of summer on the calendar. The summer solstice begins when the tilt of the Earth's axis is most inclined towards the sun, directly above the Tropic of Cancer. Ladies and gentlemen, fasten your seatbelts because on the same day, Prince Philip will be, wait for it, 100 years old. Happy birthday. However, those mentioned up here were just some of the major astronomical events that will happen during the first half of 2021. Stay tuned for the second part of the video. Insane Curiosity wishes you a happy new year. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching, everyone. Do you think 2021 will be better than 2020? What astronomical event would you like to see the most? When is your birthday? Did you enjoy this video? Let us know in the comments below. See you next time on the channel.